Huh. Hey there.
Hey, Doug, how are you?
Is that you, Sarah?
Yeah, it's me, but man, oh man, I am so tired of this.
Oh man, it's exhausting.
It's been such a year. It's just, I'm so tired of having to wear a mask and be protected.
Could you just step back a little bit, actually?
Sure.
Take a little...
Sure, I know, distance.
Man, I am over that. I'm so sick of just being safe.
I know.
Oh, wait. Is that me?
No. Oh, it's me.
Oh,
can you,
okay. Is that okay?
That?
Am I allowed
to
get it?
Yeah. It's okay.
Let's see. What does it say?
It's a notification from the CDC.
CDC?
Yeah. What? It says that if we're fully vaccinated, we don't have to wear all this protection. We don't have to wear masks. I'm vaccinated.
I'm vaccinated.
We're vaccinated.
I feel good. I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. So good, so good. I got a year. Wow, I feel nice.
Woo-hoo.
The sugar is fine.
Well,
welcome everybody. I'm Sarah Carlin.
And I'm Doug Lucey. Tonight we have with us families, alumni, employees, grandparents, and more than 200 friends of Shore.
Tonight is truly a night of celebration at Shore.
There's a lot to celebrate.
Mm-hmm.
Along with being a special moment of virtual gathering in a year that's been a little different, this is our community's opportunity to applaud employees celebrating milestone years of service.
And to honor those who will soon leave and join the ranks of other Shore legends, retired but never forgotten.
During this hour, the two of us will be your live hosts in this virtual space to come together and celebrate Shore, to remember, reflect, and honor the many groups and individuals who made this year so exceptional.
And you know, it's me and Doug, so we might find creative ways to pay homage to some of our honorees tonight.
We're so happy you're tuning in tonight, so whether you're in your living room or on your laptop, grab your beverage of choice and find a comfortable seat.
Now, let's take a look at a short video filled with images from this year, and then we'll hear from our head of school, Claire Ward. We'll be back. We'll be right back.
Earlier this month, I took a walk across campus on a sunny day. In only a few minutes, I saw so much. A group of students excitedly working on a photography project, two colleagues casually catching up, an exuberant recycling crew racing back with the bins, and a teacher sitting next to a student in front of Winslow, clearly sorting through a challenging moment. These are the scenes of normalcy, and I have never been more grateful to see them. We have walked the proverbial hot-coal challenge and come out of it stronger than we have ever been. Yes, our community is tired, but we are also excited by the promise that a summer of renewal and the next school year will bring. It's almost as if I can actually taste our resilience. This night is a long overdue opportunity to show our appreciation for the employees that make the magic happen. This includes the ones you can see and the ones who work tirelessly behind the scenes to make a positive impact on our children. While tonight honors the anniversaries and the transitions of Shore's current employees, it is not lost on me that Shore's strength this year is due in part to the groundwork laid by all of the employees, the families, trustees, volunteers, and students in Shore's past. So it is fitting that our event is one that is accessible to the broader Shore community. Shore's future is bright. We are on the verge of extraordinary growth in the breadth and depth of who we are. We are on the verge of innovation that is bound to capture the attention of not only the independent school industry, but nonprofits in general. I know these are bold statements, but because of the commitment of our community, both past and present, our future success is within reach. Tonight, let us pay tribute to our current colleagues who have made this moment in time possible.
Welcome back. What a year it's been. Mm-hmm. We are so glad you are all here with us tonight.
Hey, it looks like we have the results of the poll that everyone took while they were joining us to this virtual event.
Yes, we have people joining us all the way from Hamilton to Wenham.
Whoa, and even Beverly, maybe.
Yeah, but seriously, we have a pretty wide range here tonight. All the way from Australia, we have people tuning in.
Let's hear it for the Australians. I think it's morning time. Good morning to you.
What is that, 15 hours? That's amazing.
Yeah, something like that. That's pretty
cool. Well, good day to you out in Australia.
Well, you know, it feels a little strange in here, we have to admit. I mean, we are here in the theater. Love that, but it's a little lonely. We haven't been here for a long time, and we can't see you.
It's a little quiet. You need to make some noise, okay? Let's get some applause going.
Yeah, wherever you are, just, you know, shout it out. Let us hear you. Let us hear the love.
Come on. Let's do a little bit better than that. Come on now.
Come on. Thank you so much. That was awesome. That felt... Hold on a second.
Did that burn?
Doug, what are you doing?
Claire said we're going to be Shore strong next year. So strong. I'm going to be jacked.
Well, that's great, but, you know, we are hosting here. Can you put that down and come join you? Save it for the summer.
All right. Okay.
Actually, we've got another poll for you. For tonight's audience, we'd like you to, help us with some data. We want you to be our focus group.
As Shore looks to the future, we need some optics for the metrics. Hmm. All of you watching from the comfort of your homes, chime in.
It's your time.
Hi,
stone. And we're back. Next, we'll recognize faculty and staff who have given 5 and 10 years of their commitment, heart and soul to Shore.
There are more than a handful of them, which of course says a lot about working here. Oh, we'll also hear from the president of the Board of Trustees, Raina Lesser Hanaway. So take a sip of that lovely beverage and sit back and enjoy.
On this night of celebration, I want to take the opportunity to show my appreciation and thank you for all of Shore Country Day School's amazing employees. Now, more than ever, all of us on the Board of Trustees can't thank you enough for your dedication to our children in a year like no other. The circumstances brought on by the pandemic have been challenging for our community. Thank you for the way you have given selflessly, creatively solved problems, and risen to the occasion to meet the needs of the children. Thank you for bringing your best to Shore. Your efforts have not gone unnoticed. Here we are in May of 2021, still virtual, still dealing with the pandemic, still having our resilience tested, and finding strength and agility as we flexibly navigate this difficult environment. Since the beginning, with everything we have endured, Team Shore has gotten stronger. This experience and the sacrifices made by all of you who have helped Shore navigate this difficult situation have taught us valuable lessons that will live within Shore's culture long after the pandemic is over. The pandemic is reshaping Shore. This has been a very difficult time for sure, but there are so many positive things happening because we were forced into this very uncertain situation. We have embraced flexibility and innovation, and we have kept a long-term strategic focus instead of being paralyzed by fear and uncertainty. I am proud of everything we have accomplished over this past year. I am proud of Shore. I am proud of you. At the core of our success is hiring the right people who embody our core values and embrace our community code. I remember learning the community code with my son Charlie in kindergarten. It tells us to be kind, be true, be respectful, be open, be dependable, and be our best. Your embodiment of these aspirations has united us during the pandemic. From the bottom of my sure heart, thank you for always going above and beyond. Thank you for your unwavering commitment to our children this year and every year. This unpredictable and uncertain scenario has brought out the best in all of you. And as I complete my last month as board chair, I am pleased to celebrate the outstanding partnership I have enjoyed with you all over the past 3 years. We are stronger today than when I first assumed my chair responsibilities because we were strong together. I have collected some messages of thanks from my fellow trustees that I would like to share with you tonight. Thank you to our SHORE teachers, administrators, and staff for allowing our children to thrive despite incredibly challenging circumstances. SHORE normalized a not-so-normal situation. My child continued to feel inspired and connected to SHORE. I feel fortunate she had the opportunity to engage and learn in person with her peers and teachers. Thank you for your perseverance, compassion, dedication, and grit. What else can I say? Just the traits we hope to instill in our kids. You all have been great role models this year. I don't have kids at the school any longer, so I didn't get to experience this year at SHORE firsthand. But through my lens on the COVID task force and the Board of Trustees, I was able to see the love, kindness, and care for our kids that was shown through every decision that was made. For everyone that showed up each and every day to make this year possible for our kids, thank you. And to those retiring or celebrating major milestones, thank you for all you have done and continue to do. You rock. Thank you, SHORE, for the passion for teaching and learning in the classroom, the community spirit and encouragement on and off the field, and the boundless energy, care, and attention offered to each student and family. SHORE has made such an impact on our children this year, being in person, in too many ways to articulate in words. The communication, the support, the leadership, the quick and difficult smart decisions for the entire school community was always made with the best interest for everyone. Each person will have their own personal memories of this year, and ours will always be the numerous car rides to and from school, being truly grateful every day, getting to bring our kids to a place we knew was safe and feeling such gratitude. Seeing the happy faces, although through the masks, the skipping, the waves, and just our children being in person within this community of people is something we will never forget. Both of my kids had challenges this year. We all, the children and me, received a huge amount of individualized support from the administrators and their teachers, despite the scheduling challenges during the pandemic. The kindness, empathy, and wisdom shared with us was a huge blessing. And I was struck once again how well they know and care about our children, and really all of us. The great faculty and teachers are what makes SHORE the wonderful place that it is. Over the past 6 years, the SHORE teachers and administrators have worked to create an environment that hears and sees every student, and an environment that allows for growth and exploration. None of this would be true without the people doing the work. Thank you for all you do each and every day to create a wonderful education for my child. The sacrifice and bravery of our faculty and staff kept us all going. There wasn't a question in our SHORE faculty and staff's mind that these kids wouldn't forge ahead. In a time of a global pandemic, in a time of fear, the teachers returned united and showed all of us how to respond, behave, and really see where we could go. Thank you to the afternoon pickup crew that was always cheerful and helpful when my app was not working or I had to pick up an extra child. Rushing to pick up the kids is stressful enough, but you make the process less stressful and pleasant. Thank you to the business office for the work and effort you put into getting vaccinations for our staff and teachers, and COVID testings for all of the kids and employees that allowed school to continue safely. Thank you to my son's teachers for helping him improve his spelling and reading, weak areas for him. This may seem a bit mundane, but really encapsulates what I think makes Shore so special. The teachers are able to really get to know the students and their strengths and weaknesses. The flow of communication back and forth between the teachers and parents then allows effective intervention and improvement as a team. I am grateful to the staff and teachers for working in person to make the year as close to normal for my kids. The resilience and determination to keep teaching was especially appreciated, even though there must have been some personal cost. I am so grateful to our administrators, faculty, and staff for making Shore feel like Shore this year for our children. Even with all of the adjustments, changes, and accommodations required in light of COVID, the commitment to the school's mission and to our children never wavered. Their efforts are so appreciated. We are so grateful to the Shore faculty and staff for their tireless efforts to keep our children safe and ensure that they are keeping pace with their studies throughout the pandemic. It has never been clearer how invested you are in our children and the entire Shore community. Your dedication has been extraordinary, and we will forever be grateful for what you have done to support our children during such a challenging time for all. One thing that I am continually impressed by with the Shore faculty is their ability to support a wide range of different learning styles. I have three children who are very different types of students, and the ability of the faculty to assess each of their individual styles and needs and respond accordingly is a continual source of amazement. It is the teachers who are able to take the time and effort to really see each student as an individual with their own strengths and challenges that makes Shore relationships truly special. To provide in-person learning all year during the pandemic has required an enormous amount of additional energy on the part of our teachers and staff. They have made this all look seamless. Yet we recognize that there were many extra hours behind the scenes. Tonight and all nights, all of us on the Shore Country Day School Board of Trustees are grateful for you. We can never thank you enough for everything you did this year. I hope we have been able to convey how much we appreciate all of you. Our Shore hearts are full of love and thankfulness for you. Thank you.
I'm so looking forward to going to the Bibliophiles Ball and sharing my fairy house with everybody. But I'm thinking that maybe there's just not enough diversity. I wonder how I can make it more inclusive. I have moss and I have butterflies, but I don't know if it's really inclusive for all living beings like trolls and leprechauns. I feel like I need another perspective.
Blue moon, blue, blue moon.
Sam, the Renaissance man.
Hello there, fairy godmother Debrella. How are you?
I'm good. I'm wondering if you could maybe help me. I'm trying to figure out how to make this just more diverse and better.
Let me think about that. Well, right away I can tell. You don't have enough stuff there. We need to cram some more stuff right in there.
Oh.
How about a pyramid over here? Some hieroglyphics? Let me think. I have some old rigging from the old theater down in the rock gym basement.
Wow, you still have that, huh?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And let's see. What else? A wooden boat for the fairies to muck about in. And maybe even a sarcophagus.
Wow. Well, Sam, you have so many good ideas. I just thought maybe we could just have one or two of those elements.
Okay, very well.
And then maybe we could play.
Play? Why don't we write our own play about it?
Are you a playwright, too?
Yes, I am.
Wow, you are really a Renaissance man.
Well, you know, I have been here for so long. I've learned so much from the colleagues that have been here almost as long as I have.
As have I. You know, Maybe we can watch a video now that recognizes people who have been here for 15 and 20 years.
Good idea. And you know what else will have some ideas? Incoming President of the Board of Trustees, Amy Marks.
Wow, and then you can help me put some magic in here?
Absolutely.
All right. Well, let's go.
Here we go.
Everyone, it is a real gift to be speaking to you as we celebrate Shore's many remarkable accomplishments tonight. I'm inspired when I look at the list of incredible Shore champions who have given 5, 10, even 35 years of their dedication and love to Shore. For those of you I haven't met yet, I am the mom of 2 daughters, one currently in 4th grade and one in 6th grade right here at Shore. I'm also a developmental psychologist, a professor, a community member, and now I have the honor of being Shore's next board president. Claire and her administrative team have been encouraging us all year to reflect on what is in our Shore hearts. And as we come together tonight to celebrate our extraordinary community, I wanted to share what is in mine. When I stop to think about this past year, I am filled with such deep gratitude for this community. I actually struggle to put into words how much this community has meant to our family, so I thought I'd share some specific examples of the things that touched me and us so deeply. I think back to just about a year ago when Sam Hamlin and Ann Babcock came rolling up our driveway in a convertible, dressed in togas and wearing laurel wreaths, to hand out end-of-year gifts to all the third graders because they couldn't be together in person. I think about the way Jill Cotting and Dave Polo put in countless hours to get everyone online, stay online, and be productive online. And thank goodness for Deborah Collison and Chris Hubbard for finding safe ways to keep my voracious fourth grade reader in a book all day long. I can remember watching, not participating, as my husband and daughter tried to keep up with Mike Panozzi's Zoom workouts. I think about the unwaveringly steady, kind, and optimistic leadership that Raina Hanaway provided to the board and the COVID task force to figure out how to reopen school while caring for everyone on and off campus. I think of Kwa Do and Anthony Fry, who led our Equity and Inclusion Committee with such wholeheartedness to complete our Shore Equity and Inclusion Commitment Statement and provide clear guidance for our community as we learn to support one another through the rise in anti-Black violence and anti-Asian hate this past year. I think of Liza Jones, who empowered her fourth grade students, including mine, to place Black Lives Matter signs on campus and promote inclusivity for all who visit our grounds. I think about how our talented Strategic Initiatives Committee, guided by Elia Tessicini, is pushing us forward with new revenue-generating initiatives to ensure our school's financial sustainability. Their work is really exciting. I think of Gustavo Carrera and all of our athletics teachers and coaches who figured out how to bring sports back to the upper school just in time to help save all our sanities this spring. I think about all the staff who came together under the extraordinary care and leadership of Amanda Berg and Lewis Frank to become safe zone trainers and help make our campus even more inclusive and safe for LGBTQ+ students and families. I imagine the hundreds of ways all of our teachers learned to connect with, teach, sing with, perform with, run with, create and innovate with, and care for the young people in our lives while wearing masks and trying to maintain social distance, which I imagine may be as uniquely challenging in pre-K as it is in middle school. And lastly, I think about Shore's administrative leadership team, and I am in awe of their bravery, dedication, and commitment to not only help this community push through the pandemic, but to thrive in spite of it. I'm currently the chair of the psychology department at Suffolk University in Boston. I can tell you that in my role, on my university's many COVID task forces, I've worked about 7 days a week with not much of a break for the past year. I see firsthand the toll that this year has taken on the students in my care, the faculty who teach with me, and the staff who dedicate themselves to our programming. Claire, Gustavo, Daphne, Bill, Anne Marie, Sarah, Katie, and Celia, thank you. Thank you so very much for giving of yourselves so deeply and for reinventing your jobs, curricula, scheduling, admissions, giving, communications, and financial planning to accommodate the most tumultuous academic year I have ever been part of. These are just a few of the many things I hold close in my Shore heart. For our family, Shore was a very bright light in a challenging year, but look at what we did together. Through all of the hard work of this past year, Shore is poised for a future of tremendous success. Please join me in celebrating all of our incredible community members, their milestones, accomplishments, and the many gifts that they've given us all.
On my way to conferences. Oh no! Oh my goodness, my cart! Oh no, woe is me!
Well, hi, Alan, what's wrong?
Oh, Nurse Cronin, thank goodness you're here.
Was something happened to your cart?
Well, I'm carrying all this poetry and projects for At the Fish Houses my students have worked so hard on. I know that their parents will be so proud. I have to get to conferences.
Well, it doesn't look so good. You know, Ellen, if we regard all wheels as if they have rust, then we treat all the same.
Rust?
And we'll all be safe. But you know, I think it might be a sprain. What? I have an ice pack.
Oh, thank goodness. Oh.
Wait a minute, Ellen. What do you have in here? Are these packing peanuts?
Well,
have you been to Fenway?
I mean, J.D. Martinez did hit that amazing home run the other night.
Well, wait. Oh, my God, the cat is going into anaphylaxis.
Oh, my gosh, okay, what should we do?
Okay, call 911.
911.
Okay, you stand back. I've got an EpiPen. Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. Okay, it looks like the epinephrine is taking effect.
Well, thank...
Okay.
I'm so glad you were here and you've taken care of the physical cart, but I think we might need something to soothe its soul.
What would that be?
Some poetry. And I just happen to have a Driftwood magazine here from 2012.
Wow.
Let's see what we can have here.
Wow, that's a long time ago.
Oh, yes, of course. Kendall Kuzminskis wrote a poem called Beauty.
I remember Kendall. I think she was one of my frequent flyers.
I bet you're not the only one who remembers Kendall.
I bet there are people who have been here for 25, 30, 35 years who would remember Kendall. Maybe we can watch a video that shows tribute to them.
Fantastic. We'll read the poem and they'll watch the video.
Sounds good.
Thank you. Sarah, this really has been quite a night of celebration.
I know, Doug. I mean, just seeing how many staff have dedicated years of service with love and passion for what they do, it's pretty remarkable.
It is. Despite facing one of the most challenging years in education, they're still here. We are still here.
Yeah. And now, with all sincerity, we'd like to pay tribute to those who are closing this chapter of their lives.
Maybe to enjoy things that they just didn't have the time for until now. So, thank you. To Sam, Deb, Ellen, and Sue,
here's to you.
Tonight, we celebrate 21 years of Ellen Wright. To sit in Ellen's classroom is to experience a master teacher in action. With no pretense or need for a firm hand, Ellen meets her students where they are and takes them to all kinds of places in literature. Ellen has a way of inspiring engagement that, while it can look effortless, is actually the result of meticulous planning and preparation. One of the first things that I noticed about Ellen is her delight for the ages she teaches. She knows well the ways in which sixth and seventh graders can stumble when they do not have a framework or structure to support them. So without judgment and with a tremendous amount of positive energy, she simply provides it. Never one to raise her voice, Ellen leads with kindness and compassion for those she teaches. I loved reading former head of school Larry Griffin's description of Ellen Wright. Ellen is not in it for adulation or to compete for titles. She is in it to help each and every one of her students grow in skills, in their facility with language, and the ability to express themselves articulately with the written word. Ellen is recognized for her intellect as well as for her character and warmth. I know that all of Ellen's colleagues would agree that she is a wonderful role model for children and adults alike. Ellen, we will miss your curiosity and the cerebral way in which you are always striving to enhance your perspective in the classroom. We will miss your ability to collect everyone's attention with humility and quiet leadership. Our collective Shore hearts wish you the peace and the space to continue growing and the opportunity to spend even more time with your favorite partner in crime, Bruce. Two weeks ago, I was in the health office when a young person came in to report a stomach ache. Sue Cronin moved toward the child and got to her level after glancing briefly at the clock. What happened next was pure poetry. What did you have for lunch? Have you had any water to drink? It's so close to the end of the day. What do you have after school? With more skill and a lot more love than an official interrogation, it isn't long before the child admits that she has tennis after school and that she doesn't want to go. Without missing a beat, Sue then strategizes with the child about how she could tell mom she really isn't enjoying tennis anymore. This is just one moment in the many of Sue Cronin's days as our school nurse. It is a job that requires one to be on their toes at all times. Sue monitors concussions and chronic illnesses, calls families about falls, and she sorts out the sick from the I'd rather not go to math class in the blink of an eye. She even cares for the shore adults. And as if that was not already a big enough job, along comes COVID. Either COVID pushed her to the edge, or she decided to go out in a flame of glory. Either way, she has been our protector, our cheerleader, our caregiver, and our friend through this year and all of her time at shore. Former head of school Larry Griffin says, "What astounds me most about Sue is how she manages to make all visitors feel they are the most important people in the world at that moment, and their concern is of the utmost importance." We could not agree more. Caring with respect, with softness, or even with tough love when necessary, Sue is the consummate professional. Tonight, we celebrate 25 years of Nurse Sue Cronin. Sue, thank you for your years of commitment to shore and its community. Thank you for being my late night, early morning, and weekend partner this year as we made our way through contact tracing and quarantine decisions. You are leaving big shoes to fill, and we are honored to have worked beside you for so many years. Our collective shore hearts offer you best wishes for all of the Maine sunsets and time with your family you have earned. Play is often talked about as if it were a relief from serious learning, but for children, play is serious learning, said educator Fred Rogers. Tonight, we celebrate 32 years of Deborah Parkhurst, a teacher devoted to creating wonder both in and out of the classroom through play and imagination. From fairy houses to leprechaun traps to snowball fights in the grass on a sunny day, there isn't anything that Mrs. Parkhurst wouldn't do to engage and delight her students. This strategy is so effective that one of her students this year actually refers to Mrs. Parkhurst as his very best friend. How could kindergarten get any better than that? Current students, former students, families, and colleagues all refer to the magic of Deb Parkhurst. While some might believe that these are simply strategies deployed by a master teacher, I am here to tell you that the magic beneath this connection to her students is a mixture of love and empathy. This leaves everyone who interacts with her feeling as though they have been respected and honored. At the beginning of 1 year, a student wanted to be sure that Deb knew right away that he was going to be trouble. Rather than to meet him with power or discipline, she set out to help him develop a new identity, that of classroom helper. Within a few short weeks, he was arriving early to help his teacher prepare the classroom for the others. He felt seen and honored. He found a new version of himself, and the two of them never looked back. Larry Griffin, former head of school, reflects on Deb's magic. When a child's first step at school is greeted by the open-armed reception of Deborah Parkhurst, the child is assured of the opportunity to realize one's dreams. High expectations are achieved in a supportive cocoon that figuratively protects the child from injury when making mistakes, and it encourages both exploration and experimentation. Summoner of fairies and leprechauns, champion of imaginative play, believer in what is possible, Deb, You are a kindergarten marvel. Thank you for what you have given your students. Thank you for being a role model for kindness, both seen and unseen. Our collective Shore hearts wish you time with your family and the opportunity to spend long days with a very lucky pug named Ruby Wrinkles. Tonight, we celebrate nearly 40 years of Sam Hamlin. As most of you know, Sam is a jack of all trades. In addition to being a third grade teacher, Sam is a set builder, singer, playwright, MC, comedian, boat builder, and the list goes on. Who among us can say they have so many skills across so many areas of creativity? I still remember my very first Egyptian play at Shore when Sam wrote me into the storyline and I was face to face with a cadre of young third graders all sporting my hairstyle. I knew at this moment that in addition to all of his other skills, Sam was an observer of people, something that has influenced scores of young charges in his many years in the classroom. Sam believed all of his students were capable learners with different approaches to mastery. He recognized possibilities where others saw roadblocks. He never hesitated to simply dive in and seek creative solutions, says former head of school Larry Griffin. This not only included solutions for student learning, but I am told by Larry that Sam once figured out how to make Mary Poppins fly into the rafters on stage during a performance. Passionate about working with his hands, he never hesitated to find hands-on learning opportunities for his students. He models creativity and imagination, something to which anyone who has attended the annual Olympic Games can attest. After all, who else but Sam Hamlin could get the Shore adults to come to school on a Friday afternoon in togas and enthusiastically play the part of chariot race spectators? Sam, thank you for being Shore's embodiment of a Renaissance spirit. We are grateful for all of the hats you have worn and for your commitment to always finding a way to unlock a solution. Our collective Shore hearts send you best wishes in your next endeavors, and we certainly hope you will still visit.
I know. I can't believe it.
I mean, you think about it, it's like amazing careers. Oh, long
it's staggering.
Careers.
It's staggering. I mean, you think about how many students they impacted and then the ripple effect of who those students impacted.
Oh, I know. And us, you know? I mean...
Yeah. All the colleagues, for sure.
For sure. Wow. That's crazy. And man, oh man, retirement.
That's going to taste sweet this year, for sure.
Yeah. It'll be good for them.
Hey, so the scenes went okay?
I thought they went great.
They did?
I mean, you know, we'll see. We'll hear from people. But...
All right, so this summer I'm thinking Second City.
Really?
Maybe Steppenwolf.
Oh,
actually,
good.
I've been meaning to ask you, now that this is all done, can I keep one of the wigs?
Well, you know, you did really rock that Ellen wig.
Yeah,
I mean, I think...
I did.
What? Oh, God, we're on air. Shoot, sorry. Okay.
Okay.
Welcome back. We do have the results of the poll that you took earlier, describing a Shore education by choosing a movie title.
You know, I was kind of surprised. I thought it was going to be As Good As It Gets.
Well, this is As Good As It Gets, isn't it? But no.
Huh. Was it that when teachers need to go the extra mile, they really stretch?
And they become superheroes?
Aha. In fact, the winning movie was?
The Incredibles.
Not a big surprise, actually, to me.
And this has been an incredible evening together.
It really has. Thank you for joining us from Beverly to the West Coast and Australia.
And we're looking forward to our school's exciting future, as well as putting the pandemic behind us. It will be wonderful to see you all in person again, whether that's on campus without our masks or when our paths cross in the future.
As we close out the evening, you'll get to hear from the fabulous performance of the mashup We're All in This Together and Breaking Free from the cast of this year's virtual musical, High School Musical Junior. And then the chat will stay open for about 10 minutes if you'd like to type a shout out to any of the honorees or any of us, each other.
So thank you for joining us. It's been fun. Good night.
Good night, everyone.
Bring something to the table to help the others grow. Now's the chance to take a new direction, to see through other eyes,
to see through other eyes,
to make a choice,
to make a new connection,
to win the bigger prize.
We're all in this together. Once we know that we are, we're all stars.
Together, we make each other strong.
We're not the same,
we're different in a good way.
Together's where we belong.
We're all in this together.
When we reach, we can fly,
no one's side,
we can make it.
We're all in this together.
Once we see, there's a chance that we have.
Together, together, everyone. Together, together, come on, let's have some fun.
Together, we're there for each other every time.
Together, together, come on, let's do, come on, let's do, come on, let's do.
There's not a star in heaven that we can't reach.
If we're trying, so we're breaking free.
You know the world can see us in a way that's different from who we are.
Creating space between us, to a separate heart.
But your faith, it gives me strength, strength to believe.
We're breaking free!
Soaring, flying, there's not a star in heaven that we can't reach. If we're trying, yeah, we're breaking free.
Oh, we're breaking free!
Sky to reach for the heart.